Welcome to this brief guide on how to create and manage rules in Outlook. For many of us, getting our email in Outlook is a common everyday occurrence, but knowing how to effectively and efficiently manage and sort our emails can be a bit more of a burden. Today I'm going to show you how to use rules to make this easier. Here I have an email from the Windows Insider program, and I'm a big fan of them, and I'd love to be able to put all of their emails into one particular folder to make it easier for me to find in future. What I can do is I can right-click on the email, and if I wanted, I could use the move option and move it to the particular folder, but instead I'm going to use the option above that that says rules. And Outlook's going to suggest some basic rules for me, or if I wanted to, I could choose to create my own more advanced rules using the options at the bottom here. We'll cover those a bit later on in this video. If you'd like to as well, in the home row of your ribbon, you'll also be able to use the ellipsis menu at the end, and you can find these same options for rules right there at the top. So for this instance, we're going to start with a basic rule. The basic rule we're going to do is always move messages from the Windows Insider program. So selecting that option will give me a pop-up and ask me, which folder would I like to put this in? I've already created a folder called the Windows Insider program, so I'm going to simply select that and click on the option that says OK. That will begin my rule, and what you'll notice is that it will run the rule, and all of those emails are now going to move out of my inbox, and they're all going to be found inside the Windows Insider program folder, just like I wanted. But maybe I want to specifically get a call out for any of the emails from the Windows Insider program that mention the word Android. So what I can do instead is I can actually right click on there and go down to my rules option, and I still have those same basic options, but I need to make a more advanced rule and customize this. So I'm going to use the option that says create rule. Selecting this option will give me a slightly different pop-up where I can customize the rule to meet certain conditions. So here I can choose by the defaults where it will recommend, hey, maybe you want to select emails that come from the Windows Insider program. So I do. And then I want to change what the subject contains. So here I can delete some of these items, and I'm just going to leave the word Android here. If I hadn't selected the option for from Windows Insider program, this would include emails that come from anybody where the subject has the word Android in it. So now I have the option to tell the rule what I would like it to do. So I'm going to ask it to display the new item alert window, so I get a specific alert when that email comes in, and I want it to play a specific sound on my system as well. I can even use the browse option if I wanted to select an audio file that is on my PC. I'm now also going to ask it to move to a folder, but in this case, I'm not going to select the Windows Insider program folder like my other rule. So I'm going to select a different folder, but I don't currently have that folder available. So I'm going to select my inbox and I'm going to create a new folder. So this is going to create a subfolder inside my inbox, and I'm going to call it Android, select OK. And now I can select my Android folder and select OK again. Now I've got my settings for my rule set up, and when I hit OK, I'm going to get this little prompt. And the prompt that will pop up here in a moment says, hey, this rule is client only and will only run when this instance of Outlook is running. The question is, why is that? We sometimes see it and it's not really clear as to why we have that. So if I move that out of the way here, I can explain this for you. So some of these settings that I've selected for my particular rule, such as the option for a new item alert window and playing a specific sound, these are things that not all clients can do, especially in the case of the sound, because the sound may not exist on my other devices. So that's why I get this prompt saying that this rule will only run on this particular instance of Outlook. Now, if I'm okay with that, I can select OK, and the rule will still be applied. But now that I've got a couple of different rules that are available to me, how do I manage them? So I'm going to use the ellipsis menu, and I'm going to select the rules option, and I'm going to select manage rules and alerts. This is going to give me another pop-up where I can see all of the rules that I currently have active. At the moment, I have my Windows Insider program-based ones, and I have my client-only rule. Now, the order that these are in will come into play, and I'll show you why in just a moment. So if I go down to the bottom here, I can see that I have my conditions and actions. So the beginning is my conditions, and then underneath there is the actions that will occur when my conditions are met. And what you'll notice at the bottom is there's this option that says stop processing more rules. This is important because sometimes you could have an email that might meet both of these particular requirements. So as an example, the Android rule has come from the Windows Insider program. So if I don't have it set to stop processing rules at the end, it will then begin to process the second rule, which I can choose the order of if I want. So for instance, in this case, I want that client-only Android one to apply first, and then any other email can apply for the secondary one. If I wish to change the rule, I can use the change rule option and get some common occurrences. So if I don't want it to play a sound anymore, I can select that option and that will remove. But maybe I want the Android ones, instead of being coming with a sound, to be marked as high priority. So I can select that option as well. And now in the bottom here, I can see that instead of playing a sound, it's now told me that the action is that it will mark it as high importance. I can then also choose from here to forcibly run all of my rules right now. So when I select run rules now, I get to choose which rules would I like to run. And when I run this particular Android one, we'll see that that Android email has now disappeared out of the Windows Insider program folder and has been moved over to the Android folder that I created. And that is how you create and manage both basic and advanced rules in Outlook. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes managing your email just that little bit easier. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.